Hey everyone and welcome back to my channel. My name is Tilly and today we're going to be talking about protein. If you're new here, I'm a strength and conditioning coach with my bachelor's and my master's in exercise and sports science. Please like and subscribe if you liked this video or if you thought anything in it was useful and helpful. Now, as I'm sure we are all aware, fitness influencers are bloody pervasive online. I'm sure, as some of us existing on the internet will have noticed, just how obsessed with meeting the protein requirements they are. People think that protein consumption is going to save them from all of their problems and instantly make them massive. This is genuinely something that I have heard from some clients. But today I wanted to actually look at the research, not the fitfluencers, so that I can tell you exactly how much protein you need to be getting. Hopefully this will give you some peace of mind and arm you with the knowledge that you need to stand up to those people who are telling you that protein is everything. On the back end of this video, I thought it might be fun to go through a day of eating from my partner, who is a semi-pro rugby player, and we'll see if he stacks up and meets his protein requirements. Now, before we get into this video, I think it's really important to talk about scope of practice. I am a strength and conditioning coach and an exercise scientist. I am not a nutritionist. It is not my job to tell you how or what to eat because I am not qualified to do so. And this is the same for so many fitfluencers online giving unsolicited nutrition advice and writing meal plans. What is within my scope as a strength and conditioning coach is to provide general guidelines on what to eat and to interpret the sport and exercise science literature. The actual prescription and programming of meal plans or nutrition plans should be left to the nutritionists and the professionals in that space. I plan to leave that up to them. I highly recommend that you consult with somebody who is an expert in dietetics and they can help tailor their approach to you as an individual. With all that said, let's get into it. So let's start talking about what protein is. Protein is one of our essential macronutrients. It is made up of nitrogen and it's made by amino acids. It acts as a fundamental structural component for our muscles and for other tissues in our body. It can be used as energy as it has 4 calories per gram. However, it's not our body or our brain's preferred fuel source. Protein can be found in almost all of our food sources, from plants or animals. How much protein content is what varies. There are certain foods that have a really rich or high protein content. Some examples of these higher protein items are tofu and soy products, beans, legumes, meat, fish, dairy, eggs, nuts, and seeds. Now that we know what protein is and where to find it, let's talk about what it does for athletic performance and why people make such a fuss over it. Athletes do require higher amounts of protein than the general population. And this is because of the increased need for amino acids in the processes that our body goes through, such as maintenance, building, and remodeling of different tissues. Protein helps support our muscle growth and repair, and it helps us to hold onto our fat-free mass or our lean body mass when we're in a hypocaloric state. Hypocaloric means that you're in a calorie deficit, which means that you are eating less than you are expending. Protein intake is going to be increasingly elevated for those who are in strength and power sports. Strength and power sports athletes are going to have a higher protein intake than the general population, for sure, but they're also going to have a higher protein intake than those of us in endurance sports. It is also worth mentioning in this particular part of the video that within the sporting world, it is a very gendered environment, meaning that it is very male-dominated. And there has been an abundance of research that suggests in the Western world, eating meat is very closely tied to how we view masculinity. So it is worth considering that perhaps that really high emphasis on protein or meat consumption is coming from societal values and perceptions of health and masculinity, rather than actual science. It is important to remember this as we go through the research I'm telling you today, particularly if you feel the values I'm giving you are quite low. I'm going through some research today that is quite up to date. So these are the current values, and I've seen these across a multitude of different articles and textbooks. If you disagree with what I said about protein and masculinity or protein and meat and masculinity, then I'm happy to have a chat with you in the comments, and I'm happy to point you in the direction of some of the literature that I found because it is a really interesting read. So I just want you to keep all of this in mind as we now talk about how much protein we actually need. How much protein you actually need is going to depend on what kind of athlete you are and what stage of training you are in. It's also going to depend on your body composition goals at the time and how you feel. Generally, the acceptable macronutrient distribution range, or AMDR, for protein is 10 to 35%. This means that over all of your calories and all of your macronutrients, protein can take between 10 and 35%. So there's a massive range as to what can be seen as acceptable. I will go into more specifics. However, the current aim for strength and power athletes is to meet at least 1.6 grams of protein per kilo of body mass per day. This will help to maximize your lean body mass as you go through resistance training. If you're in a hypocaloric environment, again, which means you're in a calorie deficit, then your protein requirements might go up to be as high as 2.4 grams per kilogram per body mass per day. It might be really high because we're trying to attenuate or lessen that loss of lean body mass while we're in that calorie deficit. For endurance athletes, the current recommendations that I've seen across a few papers are about 1.2 grams to 2 grams per kilo of body weight per day. This will change depending on your training schedule, when you have your race day, and things like that. For those in the general population, the current recommended dietary allowance, or RDA, for protein is about 0.8 grams. In the UK, I think I saw a figure that was as low as 0.75. So as you can see, in comparison for our athletes, we need it to be way higher than the general population, with almost triple the values needing to be intaken to keep up with that busy training and that active life. Now, before we get into specifics of how we would meet our protein requirements during certain goals, we're going to talk about periodization and what I mean by that. Like everything in exercise science and the training process, we need to vary our training and our nutrition to meet our goals. Now, let's get into some goals that may affect your protein intake. Increasing body mass. When we're aiming to increase body mass, it is very likely and very reasonable to assume that your training volume may also increase. We usually wouldn't see a decrease in training volume during this time because it could equate to higher fat mass. And I really want to highlight that having more fat mass is not a bad thing. Just in terms of sports performance, it's not ideal as it's a non-functional mass. The increase in training volume that we would see would be in an effort to aid the increase of lean body mass that we want. During this phase, protein may move upwards from that 1.6 gram mark towards that 2.4 gram mark. And this will be to help try and stimulate that muscle protein synthesis. The exact increase is going to be dictated by your protein intake prior to this phase of trying to increase your body mass. For example, if I was eating 1.6 grams of protein before, then I might increase it to 1.8 during this phase. But if I were eating 1.4 grams before this phase, then I might only increase it to 1.6. If my partner was eating 2 grams of protein before this phase and then was trying to put on muscle mass, he might move up to 2.2 or 2.4 grams. It's really dependent on you as an individual. This small increase is also dictated by the fact that when we're bulking or when we're trying to build lean body mass, we don't want a massive increase in calories. We would usually be aiming for a modest increase in calories of about 300 to 500 calories per day, and that would have to include the increase in carbohydrate and fat content as well. So we don't need that really big jump in protein to still get the desired effect. Now, when you're aiming to decrease your body mass, we usually put ourselves in a calorie deficit or that hypocaloric state. Protein needs during this time might be higher because when we're in a hypocaloric condition, sometimes our rate of protein synthesis can reduce. So we need that higher protein content to be able to support our body. Now, for a phase in our training where we are aiming to maintain our lean body mass and we're eating a maintenance caloric intake, then the recommendations for protein are about 1.3 grams to 1.8 grams per kilo of body weight per day. During a calorie deficit, we might go much higher than this though, all the way up to 2.4 in order to combat that reduced protein synthesis that I mentioned. Now, just quickly before I move on, you guys may have heard that you can go all the way up to 4.4 grams of protein per kilo of body weight a day. And I've seen this study as well. This particular study that is quoting this is on bodybuilders who are in a severely hypocaloric environment because they're getting stage ready. And that is not the practice that all of us should be following. We usually only want small changes in body mass at a time so that it doesn't affect our training and it doesn't affect our performance in the gym, on the field, on the track. Now, when do we eat protein? With all of those goals being discussed, I think it's really important to talk about how much protein our body can actually absorb at one time. So while your body may need 1.6 grams of protein per kilo of body weight per day, that doesn't mean that we would eat that all in one sitting. The range of how much your body can actually absorb at a given time, it can range all the way from 0.25 to 0.4. So it's obviously very individual. I would hazard a guess that my partner would be at the higher end and I would be at the lower end. If I were to calculate this for myself, I'm about 75 kilos. That would mean that for each meal, my body could only absorb about this amount. For my partner, 120 kilos, for each meal, he might be able to absorb this kind of range. It really varies. I have seen some studies that say you can't absorb more than 20 grams of protein per sitting, and others that say much, much higher. I think the most practical advice I can give you in this space is to just split up your protein intake throughout the day. You want to eat it when it's going to best support you, your training sessions, and your mind. For example, if my current goal is about 120 grams of protein per day, then I could split this over 3 to 4 meals and a snack. I might have a protein snack like a peanut butter sandwich or a protein bar after my training sessions. And if I train really late at night or if I don't feel hungry afterwards, I might have a protein shake or some form of liquid protein so that I can support my digestion and still meet my protein requirements. There's so many ways that you can do this. I now thought it would be really fun to have a quick look at some of the meals that my partner eats throughout the day so that we can track his protein intake versus his protein requirements. He is a semi-pro rugby player and he is a vegetarian, so it'll be interesting to see how he stacks up. Callum is in season right now or in the competition phase of his annual plan. He would be aiming to maintain his muscle mass and give his body enough protein so that it can repair after games effectively. As he is in the maintenance phase, like I said earlier, he would be aiming for 1.3 to 1.8 grams per kilogram of body mass per day. If he was eating less and aiming to lose weight, then he would move further up that scale in terms of protein requirements. Now let's have a look at some of his meals. Let's see how he stacks up. So from that, we realized that Callum ate about 158.4 grams of protein a day. So it's a little bit on the low end for him, but we had a really lazy day and didn't do much cooking. So that was his day. As you can see, he met that maintenance requirement of about 156, so 1.3 grams. And usually he would get a bit more than that. It seems to be working for him. It's supporting his training. He's still able to put on muscle and hit PBs. So yeah, that's the end of the video. Let me know if you have any questions. Thanks for watching. Well done if you made it this far. It was awesome to have you. And remember to like and subscribe. We'll see you next time. Bye.